talk about treatment options for estrogen and progesterone.
Let's say that you come in, we do a consultation, we determine that hormone optimization is something that you want to move forward with. So we will do education then about the kinds of treatment options that are available. So estrogen, for example, all right? We don't give estrogen by mouth, even though that's commonly done. It's standard of care out there, okay? We don't do that because the increased risk of blood clots and the increased risk of stroke with estrogen therapy all comes from oral estrogen. So we don't do that. We do estrogen either transdermally, which is through the skin, and you can do that either by putting a gel on your inner thigh every day, or you can actually use a little patch that adheres to the body, and that's changed usually every 3.5 days. The other thing that we can do, which is a little different, is basically a estrogen implant. And we make a small incision in the skin at the hip. After we numb that area up, we put in an individualized dose of estradiol, and that individualized dose goes into the subcutaneous space. It sits there and releases a tiny amount of hormone every day. And depending upon your metabolism and your needs of estradiol, that can last anywhere from 3 to 5 months.
Well, that's fairly convenient then.
Exactly, yeah, because it's not something you have to remember to do every day. Progesterone, 99.9% of my women are on oral progesterone because one of the most common complaints that I hear from women over and over is, I can't sleep and I'm anxious. Oral progesterone takes care of both of those things. So we take it at night before bedtime. We get great blood levels. And by the way, progesterone is important because it protects the breast tissue from the actions of estrogen and also protects the lining of the uterus, if you still have a uterus, from the actions of estrogen as well. And that's actually why we designed progestins in birth control pills to act like estrogen. The biggest difference is progestins only act in the uterus because that's how we designed them, but they don't protect the breast tissue, which progesterone does. They also don't have the benefits for mood, they don't have the benefits for sleep, they don't have the benefits for anxiety, and progesterone also helps skin and hair. If you've ever been pregnant,
we like that.
Yeah, if you've ever been pregnant, you remember how full your hair was during your pregnancy. That's the acts of progesterone. So there's a lot of good reasons to continue with that.
I've heard you're treating women with testosterone. What's that all about?
We think of testosterone as primarily a male hormone, and it is the primary male hormone, but it's very important for women. For women, testosterone is important for having good lean muscle mass, good bone mass. It's important for a sense of well-being, for a sense of energy. Most importantly, we find that women without testosterone don't have a desire for sexual intimacy. And we use very, very low doses of testosterone. On, you know, 1/10 of what we use for a male is what we use for a female. And we administer that a lot of the same ways we do the estrogen, which is either through the use of a compounding gel, which we get from a compounding pharmacy, that you put on your shoulders every day, or like we talked about with the estradiol, you can use the implant as well.